Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we're continuing with the Hemingway knurling tool. We're making the trunnion, and also I'll be making the pins that hold the knurling wheels. Now I'll show you how I cut the slots in the pins, and also how I use the dividing head to machine the radiuses and the arcs. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Here are some of the parts we made in the previous episodes, and today we're starting on the dividing head, which I'm using as a rotary table. Now, to machine the radii on the arms, I made this, which is just a number 2 Morse taper, a shortened version, with a 1/4 inch locator on the end that slots into the middle of my dividing head, and then the part just fits on there, and by turning the dividing head the cutter will move round and do these arcs. It also stops the part moving. I can clamp up on the side here, but this will stop the part moving off centre, where before I just had a couple of clamps centred it, and I found it would move off centre as I was machining. Well, with this it can't move off centre. Then if you need a bigger hole for other objects, you just make some bushes, they slide over the top to increase the diameter of the location. So for the other end, that's too big, so make a small bush, slides over, then that locates on there. The setup, because it's a round brass bar, I've held it in a collet with a square block so I can turn that round. I've centred on the centre of the brass bar, and then I've moved the tool out and down. So I'm going to cut straight across and form one side of the guide. Okay, that should be 0.4375. That's 0.437,
just under 0.439, 1.5 thou over.
I'll leave it at that. I can always file a bit off to fit the slot. So now I'll move it over and do the other side. Same depth. And that should fit in this slot. Yep, that's a good fit, no play in that. All I've got to do now is turn it round and do the other side. I'll set this in the vise, 2 parallel strips just to locate it level. And I've set this true just by using a slip gauge or a gauge block between the jaw and the face. And I've got to the centre between the 2 vice jaws, and I've spot drilled. Now I need to drill a 3/8 hole. Let's take the fraise off the edge.
I'll set it up in the lathe to part it off to length. I've now placed the part I cut off into the chuck. I've measured the width. I'll now turn this to the correct length.
I've just finished the trunnion and just drilled and tapped. That part's finished. Now I need to make the main screw. This form on the end is just to locate this on. The two grub screws go into this groove and it stops it coming off. But it still lets it twist. I'm just making some bushes that fit in the side plates. All I've done is turn the outside down a couple of thou over and drilled and reamed the inside. It's 5/16 on the inside, 3/8 on the outside. So now I want to part this off in half inch lengths. I might get, should get two out of this. I'll have to pull that out the chuck a bit. Don't think I'm going to get another half inch out of that. And here are the two bushes fitted in the plates. I'm just making the pins that hold the knurling wheels. What I'm doing, I've just put a dome on the end, then I'll put a bush on there just to give me a shoulder, and then with my slitting saw,
otherwise known as a hacksaw,
rest it up against the bush. And then you can saw the slot. Once you're to the correct depth, you can part that off. I used the bush on here before just to stop me coming sliding along and damaging all the surface, and it gives you a position, something to
guide the saw against.
That's about a 32nd deep, so all I want to do is polish that up, cut it off to length. Once you've got the length, it's easy just to saw it off.
I've placed it back in the chuck and put a dome on the other end. And that's the first of the two pins that hold the knurling wheels in position.
This is the knurling tool I'll normally use. And I think if I was making this again, I wouldn't drill the hole a quarter of an inch straight through. I'd make it a smaller hole so you could use a screw like that to hold an knurling wheel. In fact, that would nearly fit in the knurling tool. A lot simpler, just a thread on the bottom and a countersink in this end. That goes through. The screw goes in and you tighten the screw up. And those screws hold the wheels in position. A lot neater and quicker than having to drill holes in the side and make a plate that links into the spindle in the middle to hold it in position. Just two screws. This is what we've made so far. The arms, the body, little cam, the pins for holding the knurling wheels, the lever for the quick release, and this guide plate with the trunnion in one end with the thread, and this piece slides up and down two grooves in the plates. So I think I've got two more pieces to make, which I'll be doing next week. One is the main screw that goes through here, and the other is the two little plates that hold the knurling wheel pins in position.
And I also have to cut the slots for the knurling wheels in the arm. Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Next week we'll continue with the machining of the feed screw and build and test.